Namaste guys, this is Ashmita from artsandcraft.blogspot.in, and I have a really pretty mini album to share with you guys. And it's been a while since I've done a video and shared a project, and I feel really bad to send them out without doing a video or taking photographs. But life's been a bit crazy and I can't film and photograph them fast enough as they go up. So I would have really felt bad if this one went without a video. So here it is. So this is an album that I've been sharing some sneak peeks of. And that's what the spine looks like. It is meant for a little baby girl. So I have some cute little charms there. A wing, a butterfly, an elephant, and a seashell. And if I can only, yes, get it the right way. So, and I have a fun little swivel thingy that holds all of my charms. And this is pretty neat. You can move it around and it doesn't, and it's pretty fairly flat. So this is my cover, and I hope I'm getting it in frame. So I've left this unattached, and I have a little piece of patterned paper stuck behind there for reference, so they can add the picture of the baby and then glue the entire thing down. So I did a couple of layers for the cover, and I added some pretty mulberry flowers. And I used the Prima Bedtime Story paper collection, and I used some of the wooden icons as well. I fussy cut this little girl. And I already undid the bow. I'm just getting ahead of myself, but I does have a ribbon closure. It's a velvet ribbon, and I really love this. Really vintage and soft, like the color scheme that's going on in the book. So let's just quickly have a look inside. And you have a little place here where the details of the baby can go. And I seem to have lost my journaling card, but it does have a journaling card there. And on here you have a flap that flips open, and then another one this way, and you have plenty of places for photos and journaling. And what I did was, since I only did 6 pages, I meant each of the pages to be per month front and back. So I have 2 tags in each of the pockets for each of the months to record the first year of the baby. And there are a few pieces here that are not from the collection. Like this, for example, is from the debutante, and I thought it just really went, and it needed some bit of paint to make it pop. So behind here on the second page you have a beautiful fold out. And I did use a lot of the 4x6s as well. And then here you have the cute little Humpty Dumpty. I really love this collection. It is so perfect for an album. And then I won't be pulling out all the tags. They're pretty similar. So you have another fold out. Some more of the 3x4s. And then you have some cards here. And this folds out. And there's plenty of room for photos and journaling. And a lot of pockets. I tried to add a lot of interaction, even though it was a small book. But I did a lot of flaps. And here you have some more interactive elements. Love those cute little piggies. And again, you have more of those piggies again, and some journaling cards. And and this flips back on. Again, this little flap folds out. This folds this way, and this goes this way. So plenty of room for photos. And this is the last page. This flips down. This flips down as well. And here I just did a little waterfall for more photos. And then down there I have a pocket and some more of the 3x4s. So that's the back. It's similar to the front. And I do have a special little thing to share along with this album, because this doesn't go on its own. It does have a little box to go with it. And I haven't gotten around to the embellishing yet. I will be adding some little embellishments to this one. And I hope you can see that in the finished photos. But let me describe the box to you. This is a simple chipboard box that I made, and I did use the A4 sheets from the Garden Fable, because I only had the 6x6 that I used to create the album. So I chose colors that would go with the collection, and I thought this went pretty well for a little girl. And it's pretty sturdy, and I just love the way it turned out. And if you're wondering what this is, I created this frame, the shadow box frame, and it has a little silver spoon, and that is an actual silver spoon. And I used my inscription pen. I have this metal pen that you can use to write on metal, and I etched the name of the baby girl onto it. It's Elisha, and I didn't do a really good job. I'm still practicing with it, but I think it turned out pretty neat. So, and I also did a little heart, and I'm not sure how much of this is getting on the camera, but I will share photos of this without the acetate on top, and I hope you can get a better look at my handiwork with the etching. And this top just flips open, and it's pretty snug. So let's just fit the book back in. And I'm just going to do the ribbon. Make a pretty bow. Oops. There you go. And I'm going to slide my album right into it, and it fits in perfectly like so. And on goes the cover. So it's pretty snug, because I do need to ship this, and it's pretty sturdy. It's not going anywhere, and I'm really happy. So I hope the people who are receiving this are going to love it as much as I loved creating this. And if you guys enjoyed my work, don't forget to press that little red subscribe button on the bottom and leave a comment. Visit me again soon. Bye bye.